House, and I think they're going to give a level of stability, and I think they're going to be a great help to General Kelly.
Okay, Chris, I want to turn to the president's mindset about this interview with Stormy Daniels, the interview with Karen McDougal. Did he watch those interviews and tell us what he's thinking?
Well, you know, I can't tell you everything he's thinking. I can only tell you what he told me. He said he thought that much of the Stormy Daniels stuff was a political hoax. Again, those were his words. You know, you, Martha,
I so think he thinks very- they're lying. Even though Stormy Daniels got $130,000.
I'll let him characterize. You know, you have to look at this case. You're a straightforward journalist. I really think you're fair-minded. When you watch this this interview on CBS 60 Minutes, you're going to be looking for the same question I'm looking for. Are they going to ask her, Stormy, why did you hire a political hit Democratic attorney, Michael Avenatti, who's worked for 150 Democratic political campaigns, Joe Biden's campaign, worked for Rahm Emanuel, who's operating on funding her tremendous public relations effort? And, you know, at the bottom line is there's never been a claim of harassment. So the president looks at this, and I think he's looking at it like I am looking at it. This is politically motivated to hurt and embarrass him in some way. And you know what? At the end of the day, the poll numbers for the president are up. Gallup has him at a record 40%, the Rasmussen at 48% approval. So I think the American people are really dismissing this as political witch hunts.
Okay, Chris, thanks for that. And I want to turn to Dan.